just looking around the show here, because actually I'm going to let you today into some secrets of EV charger. Now, behind us, we've got some gorgeous looking chargers from EN Plus that we haven't seen on the channel before. But the first secret is, these actually aren't chargers. Now, people who have been in the comments before, you're right. Actually, these AC chargers don't do any charging whatsoever. The charging takes place in the car. So, why do we call them EV chargers? Well, that's what everybody else calls them. And if we didn't do that, you wouldn't find our videos. But today we're actually going to look at a fast charger, which brings me on to the next secret I'm going to let you into. Because sometimes you'll see these very familiar connectors here that we used to, the Type 2 connector, which they can charge a car at 22 kilowatts. But the actual things itself, these connectors, although they may be able to put 22 kilowatts into the car, the onboard charger within the car actually dictates the charging speed and the power that we can charge the batteries at. So you may buy your car, plug into a 22 kilowatt charger, and then be very disappointed to find out that it only charges at 7 kilowatts, because that's what's built into the car. Now, familiar brands, we had a Vauxhall Corsa the other week, which would charge at 7 kilowatts. If you've got a Tesla Model 3, you can charge at 11 kilowatts if you've got a three-phase supply. If you've got the X, you may be able to go up to 16 kilowatts. So if you're buying an EV car, watch out for those expensive additions in there. Don't worry about the leather interior. You may want to trade up to a faster onboard charger to enable three-phase charging at some of those higher power levels up to 22 kilowatts. But if you really want faster charging, we need to be looking at DC charging, which is where this device comes in behind me. Now, it does look like a petrol pump, so we can feel a little bit more comfortable, can't we? Because we know that petrol can obviously put energy into a car incredibly quickly. This charger here behind us has lots of different charging options, but the one we're going to look at today is the DC charging option. And this box behind us can put 120 kilowatts of DC charge straight into the car. So before we take a sneak peek at what's inside this fantastic box behind us from EN Plus, let's familiarize ourselves with the connectors we use for EV charging. So the AC one will be familiar to most drivers because this is the Type 2 connector. We've got our communication pins there that we've looked at in videos before for that PP and CP state. And then we've got our three phases, neutral and the CPC, or the earth wire as we may call it. So that's very familiar to people, but that's when it comes to DC fast charging. Let's pull out this beast here and look at this meaty cable behind us. And then you'll see we've gained an additional two connection points here, which are for DC high current charging. We've still got our CP and PP state connectors and our protective conductor there as well. And this is what is now standard for most cars. So if you open the flap on your EV car now, you'll see a combination of the Type 2 and these two CCS2 connectors here for high power charging. So let's have a little sneak peek at what's inside this cabinet. Push the release mechanism there, and we're in. Now, we've looked at lots of AC chargers on the channel before. When you step up to DC, there's naturally a lot more inside the charger, including actually the electronics to do the charging, which is no longer in the car. But let's take a little journey through what we've got going on here. So obviously a very healthy rated circuit breaker at the input of the device. So here's where our AC supply comes in there. We've got some extensive EMC filtering because obviously there's a lot of power electronics in the box there. You can also see down here we've got all important surge protection and the circuit breakers for the AC charger that's also on the front of this. We're not looking at that in this video. We've done enough of that. Moving up, here's the actual conversion stage itself. So inside behind these panels here is the power electronics to convert the AC into the DC charging current that we need for the car. However, there's also two controllers. It's still important to talk to the battery management system in the car, because obviously we know batteries, it's critical that you charge them under the right conditions. So temperatures are very important. The state of charge of the battery itself in the car is also important, because you'll find as DC charging, you can charge very quickly when the car battery is empty. It slows down as it gets towards 80% and up to 100%. And to do that, we've got two communication modules here that talk directly to the battery charging system within the car to ensure that you may not need actually 120 kilowatts at that particular time. It will be regulated to suit the demands of the car itself. Now, you're probably thinking now, who wouldn't want to charge at 120 kilowatts and have one of these on their driveway so they could charge their batteries in less than an hour? Well, let's think about the practical implications of charging at this power level. So 120 kilowatts, well, that's equivalent to almost five regular power supplies that you'd put into a UK home. So obviously the power infrastructure back to the grid to support this is extensive. So where would you use DC fast charging? Well, these are obviously ideal for places where you need to charge cars fast. So think of motorway service stations. If you're a business who has possibly a fleet of vehicles, possibly delivery trucks, and you want to bring them in, get them recharged and quickly back out on the road as quick as possible. And then we also thought of those other things. Think of those car dealerships where you need to charge a lot of cars in a single location and you don't have a lot of time to do it in. Car rentals. So lots of car rental fleets are starting to move over to electric vehicles. People typically bring them back at night empty, or they do in case of electric, because they don't want to be hanging around to charge them up. So you need to turn those vehicles around as quickly as possible. This is the kind of charger that you probably need in there. Would you have one at home? Well, if you're a multi-car family and you've got 20 kilowatts available coming into your house, possibly you've got a small three-phase supply, this might be something we start to see moving forward. So the EN Plus brand is probably a new one for viewers in the UK. They are one of the biggest charging brands in China. Let's just briefly return to slow charging. If you've got people hanging around for quite a while to charge their car, well, why not throw in some advertising? And this is a product that's coming to the UK later this year, where we've got an EV charger with built-in LCD screen where we can serve up advertising. Perhaps offer them a tasty treat while they're waiting to charge the car, or an offer where they can get one at a significantly discounted price. So one last secret. Well, it's not really a secret. Why are we wearing green t-shirts while we've been down here at Futurebuild? We're actually promoting our new channel, eFIXX Energy, where we go way beyond the world of EV charging and electrical, but we've actually strayed into the world of plumbing, into heat pumps, into heat storage. So if you haven't seen that channel and you're interested in all these new green technologies for that future building that we're going to be living in, check out that channel. I will leave a link for that in the description below. But for now, fire your comments in when it comes to fast charging. Have you installed something that I've now known as the charge rocket behind us? Have you installed the infrastructure behind it? We'd love to have your experience and your comments about fitting for this type of equipment.